Hi everyone, I'm Soumya from team number 18. Let us introduce my team members Anjali, Abhishek and Mustafa. My team members, here our project duck shooting gaming machine works on slider crank mechanism where the rotatory motion of DC motor provides straight line motion for the slider. We did this engineering exploration cross project under the guidance of Mr. Raghuraj Adi. Coming to the problem definition, we can define our project as a semi-automated gaming machine which is able to do the accurate gaming process. It should be portable, user-friendly and it should be exciting and entertaining. Machine should be within 4000 rupees only and it should have minimum weight. And it should work 2 hours continuously. And players have the limited chances to complete the game in the provided time. Functions like releasing the laser light, working of button in the laser pointer, taking force from the user to release the light, proper provision for holding the ducks, sensing the laser light, and there should be a proper base for the complete machine so that the machine can be held firmly and it should indicate the completion of game. For this functional tree and functional clustering, we should first identify the functions and then categorize under the main functions. As you can see here, duck movement, sensing, display, and indication as more 4 main functions, and the identified functions are categorized under the main functions. And by using these main functions and sub functions, we make these clusters: motional unit, sensing unit, and displaying unit and interface unit, as you can see here in the figure 2. With the help of functional clustering, we identify the 4 subsystems. They are motional unit, sensing unit, displaying unit, and interface unit. Identification is very important so that they help in building our prototype very easily. Shooting gaming machine, we generated the 4 concepts. Here in first picture, it works based on the slider crank mechanism, and the second one works based on the rack and pinion mechanism, where the ducks are placed on a sliding part. When it slides, all the ducks move at a time. Here we use only 1 DC motor. In the third concept, works only on 1 DC motor and it will be like a ferry wheel. The fourth concept, all the ducks connected to each duck connected with the DC motor and they rotate around itself. The common thing here is LDR placed on the eyes of the ducks, and player should play and he should give the laser light from the laser pointer at a particular distance, and he should shoot the duck to complete the game. One best concept among the generated concept is difficult. It will be made very easy by selecting a prioritized objectives and assigning the weightage for them. With this information, bug chart can be generated for 4 these concepts by considering the one concept as a datum. From the total score of each concept, we got this as our selected concept as it got highest score. In this concept, we are placing the slider crank vertically so that the rotatory motion of DC motor provides the up and down movement for the ducks. Because ducks are connected to the sliding part, whenever the slider moves, the ducks also move. When the LDR sensor senses the light, LED gets on. When the LDR is not getting any laser light, then the LED gets off. In virtual implementation, 3D modeling for the selected concept helps us to build the prototype. As coming to the 3D modeling part, we require a slider crank mechanism. So these are the some parts of the slider crank. Here we can see the connecting rod. This connects between the slider and crank. This is the slider. Here we can connect a duck by this rectangular leg of this duck is connected to the slider, and here is the wheel or disc. We can see here the hole through which the shaft of the DC motor comes, and nuts and bolts are used for connecting between the different parts. Here we can see a 3D modeling for DC motor. This is the shaft. This shaft of the DC motor through the disc hole of the slider crank, it connected to the crank, and this is the mechanism, slider crank mechanism. We can see the slider crank mechanism. The slider crank mechanism requires a slider crank disc connecting rod. Here we can see all the assembly of this slider crank and all. And here is the slider. Here we can connect a duck. Whenever the DC motor starts rotating like this, the slider moves along with this, the duck connected with the slider also moves. This is the complete 3D model for our gaming machine. Here we can see the ducks. Whenever the DC motor rotates, the ducks moves up and down, and a player shoot the duck, and he should shoot exactly on its eye so that the sensor placed on its eye can recognize it and LED gets on so that the duck gets shooted. Inside weave of 3D modeling for our duck shooting gaming machine. Here we can see the ducks with the eyes where the sensor were placed, and DC motor and crank were connected to the sides of the box. This is the complete 3D modeling for duck shooting machine. For duck shooting gaming machine, we require the circuit as shown in the picture. DC motor, relay module, LDR sensor, LEDs, Arduino Mega 2560 and resistors are used here to construct the circuit diagram. We use the circuit.io, which is the online platform which helps to construct this circuit. This flowchart explains the working of our gaming machine. When we start the game, DC motor and the sensors were on, and when DC motor completes its one rotation in only one direction, as we set it in to rotate in only one direction, slider completes its one up and down movement, so duck moves up and down. When the player shoots the duck with laser pointer, LDR senses the light and gives the indication as duck shooted by the player. LEDs helps us to give the indication for duck shooter. And when the LED is off, then the player may stop shooting the duck. Here in bill of materials, we require 5 DC motors, 5 LDR sensors, 5 LEDs, and the ducks are made up of foam sheets, base supporter, rocker, jockey and slider supporter, and these are the some parts. And the supporter, rocker, jockey are made up of acrylic sheets, and the duck base and the body part and the slider part are made up of foam sheets, and the slider supporter is, we are using the aluminium sheets. Coming to the DC motor sizing, here first we calculated the force and torque from the torque value. We identified the DC motor specifications by using the DC gate motor specifications chart. And here we got the torque as 6.354 kg cm, so it is providing the RPM in between 15 to 30. Coming to the battery sizing, maximum current consumed by the DC motor is equal to 300 mA. So battery capacity is the multiplication of number of working hours and the maximum current consumption. So we got 900 mAh. So we require the 5 DC motors with the 900 mA capacity at 12 volt. Coming to the functional specifications, we identify the 7 functions and their specifications. First one is indication as a game starter. Duck movement itself indicates the game starter. Second one is the provision for holding the duck, the slider which provides the space for holding the duck. The third one is releasing the laser light, the laser pointer which releases the light. And the fourth one is sensing the laser light, LDR sensor with 5 mm diameter and 0.02 kg which senses the light within its range. Proper base for the holding this machine is given by the 30 centimeter square base, and the sixth one is the indication as the duck got shooter by the player. That is done by the LED. When the duck got shoot, then the LED turns on. And the last one is the indication as game over. When all the LEDs turns on, then this shows that the game is completed.
Now I will explain about our project model, which materials we are going to use and what are the connections about and how is the how about the program. Now first we are using 5 LDR sensors and 5 LED lights, 5 DC motors for and 5 single switch motor driver and Arduino Uno. In this we are going to use all 5 DC motors, 5 LDRs, 5 LED lights. In order we are using 5 ducts. First let me explain the connections. DC motor is connected to the DC, the one end of the DC motor is connected into relay module and the other end it is connected to the battery. Later connections is made as we have shown in this circuit. Later we have used 5 LED light in order to indication of working of LDR sensor. I mean if a person shoots to the duck, the LDR sensor have to detect the light. I mean if a person shoots the laser light to the LDR sensor which is present in the duct, it have to detect and it have to give the notification in order to give an in order to message us that whether he shooted to the duck or whether he shooted to the LDR sensor or not. For indication we have used it as a light indicators. Next, later let me explain about the program or coding. As LDR sensor is an analog device which works on analog inputs itself. So we have connected 5 LDR sensor to the analog outputs of the Arduino Uno, that is A0, A1, A2, A3 and A4. And as we have to declare the constant because it is a variable or something characters. So we have declared it before itself. Later, let me explain the working of LDR sensor. We have mentioned the number 216, that is, it's a fixed one. If it is more than, I mean, light intensity or it's something, it detects and it says the numbers. If it is more than that, then only we have mentioned the case that if LDR sensor detects the light, I have mentioned if by using if else case. I have made the working of LDR sensor. I mean, if LDR sensor is greater than 216, then the digital write 13 itself means the digital write 13, 12, 11, 10, 9. These are the 5 LED outputs. I mean, 5 LED pins which we have connected. So we have made respected LDR sensor to respected LED pin output. So if one LDR sensor is if LDR sensor detects the light, the respected LED will be glows because we have made programming like that. You can see our programming. And regarding about DC motor programming, I will say you that it's a random one, and it is one of the easiest one. There is nothing in that. We have made a DC motor because crankshaft mechanism, it needs a little time. So we have made a, because we need only in crankshaft mechanism we need only one direction rotation of a DC motor. So we are using a single channel relay and it doesn't requires a double channel relay. So in this we will get only digital, only one pin. So we have took 5 pins for 5 DC motors, each pin for a single DC motor. And first, for the first, we have choose one random DC motor. Like we have took that 3, 4, 5, 7, 8. These are the pin numbers we have taken to the DC motor. Let me rectify. Okay, these are the pins taken to the DC motors. For example, I will take a pin number 3 and it is connected to one random DC motor. And this I will give this DC motor as a high for a delay around 2 to 3 seconds. Later I am going to do that low because first for the 2 to 3 seconds it have to move. I mean the DC motor have to complete one rotation. For one rotation it takes around 2 to 3 seconds, and this programming can be modified on the basis of trial and error process. If trial and error process after the building the project, we have to do the trial and error because we have to know what's the time taken by the DC motor to complete one rotation. Because one rotation of DC motor leads to one rotation of crankshaft. One rotation of crankshaft leads to one up and down, one complete up and down movement of the duct. So on the basis of trial and error, we have to change the delay. First, we have given delay at 2 to 3 seconds. That is the delay 2000 to 3000. First, I am going to give a pin number 3 as a high, and for 2 to 3 seconds it will be high. Later, I am going to give that pin number, remaining pin number, remaining 4 pins will be low. And later, I am going to give that pin number, that 3 pin number as a low, and remaining any one random I will select and I will give that as a high. Later, this process will be continued. Later, after getting all 5 pins high, I mean, first chance 3 is going to get high, next chance 4 is going to get high, next chance 6th is fifth is going to get high, next 7th, next 8th, like this. After all 5 DC after all 5 working of DC motor, at the end I'm going to give all pins as low, all pins DC motor as low, because all pins have to stop their work.